In this intense scene, Oscar Isaac's character, Duke Leto, flies alongside his son, Paul Atreides, as a colossal sandworm emerges from the depths of the desert, forcing them to make critical life and death decisions for the crew of the Spice Harvester. The cinematographer, Greig Fraser, faced the challenge of working within tight limitations, particularly in terms of the lighting, to authentically capture the true essence of the desert environment. Dune is a cinematic adaptation of Frank Herbert's iconic science fiction novel, brought to life by director Denis Villeneuve. It is a testament to the collaboration between Villeneuve and Fraser. With their keen eye for detail and ability to immerse audiences in the story. The Spice Harvester sequence presented a unique set of challenges for Fraser and his team. To achieve an immersive experience, practical effects were employed, creating an authentic look and feel. They chose to shoot on location instead of relying on LED screens, allowing the desert to become an integral part of the storytelling.
But it's just that I'm old-fashioned, you know, it's like it's just that I need reality to be inspired. And on the day when we shoot for the light, for the actors, it's old school, but I'm not unfortunately, I can't work in virtual environments. I wish I could.
Villeneuve and Fraser were obsessed with the idea of natural light and the movement of sunlight on the characters as the ornithopter spins around the worm. This focus determined how the moment was executed. Building upon practical effects, the team constructed 12-ton ornithopter models for interior shots, ensuring a seamless blend between the actors and their environment. To achieve flexible movement and rotation of the ornithopters, a specially designed gimbal was constructed on a hill, enabling dynamic camera work. This simulated the flight pattern, with giant fans creating the wind. One of the key challenges was deciding on the placement of the camera. We decided to fix the camera, where possible, to the body of the ornithopter, Fraser stated in an article by Vanity Fair. We explored shooting this shot from ship to ship, meaning motivated by a camera from another ornithopter, but decided that a camera fixed to the fuselage would create a much stronger image, putting our characters firmly in relation to the sandworm. In Dune, the unpredictability of the desert becomes a character of its own. The shifting sands and the play of light and shadow all contribute to the visceral experience that Fraser captures through his lens. As Dune Part 2 approaches, the ornithopter scene remains highly relevant, exemplifying the craftsmanship we can expect from Fraser and Villeneuve in the upcoming installment. We recently hit the 1,000 subscriber mark, so I just want to say a big thank you for all of your likes, for all of your comments, for all of your watch time. I'm so grateful to you all. Thank you so much. As a content creator, this marks a turning point for my channel. I have some exciting new projects coming up, so if you haven't subscribed, please do so and stay tuned. I'm David. Thank you so much for watching.